In summer sadness news. Aww. Summertime sadness.
That's a stretch.
That's not the same song. Those are two different songs.
Submitted by Just Kidding.
That was
Farce.
Like the worst duet I've ever heard.
I know, and when you looked at me like you were on the same page, I'm like, yeah.
That is why rehearsals are important.
Yeah.
She was singing that the other one.
Yeah,
it was like 11-year-old air band.
We were singing the same song, I think.
No, we weren't.
So the National Alliance on Mental Illness explains how gorgeous summer days can make some people miserable.
What?
Oh, shit, how?
People have too much time.
Have you heard of June gloom?
Yeah. No.
What is that?
I think there's like an overcast during June and then people get sad.
But it says gorgeous summer.
Yeah, it's a beautiful day. It makes you sad.
I heard if something traumatizing happens to you in your childhood during a sunny day, then whenever it's sunny and pretty, you get the same emotional stuff.
That's true.
Dude, something happened to Nikki during an overcast day.
I don't know what happened, but
that makes sense though. Like if it feels shitty and then something shitty happens.
Yeah.
But for me, if something shitty happened, it was an awesome day. The awesome day actually makes it feel less shitty.
Maybe it wasn't shitty enough.
Yeah, like what if a cloud farted at you on your birthday and it was a sunny day?
I might not cry, but if it was a gloomy day, I probably would cry.
The setting just makes it worse when it's gloomy.
Yeah.
Right.
But what if like your mom died on a sunny day?
That's the wrong person to involve.
Then it'd be less sad because it's so sunny.
He wouldn't care.
Wow.
Great.
Lies.
Okay.
Yeah, so the National Alliance on Mental Illness.
No heart, dude.
It's right here.
So the National Alliance on Mental Illness.
I didn't know there was an alliance.
I'm with Joe on this because does that mean they were beefing before? All the mental groups, they were divided.
No, they were like superheroes. Yeah, they were like superheroes fighting it independently. And then... Yeah. Like Voltron.
So something big happened where they all had to team up.
Yeah, what were the different groups? Like ADHD crew. Yeah.
Bipolar.
Yeah, bipolar committee. And then they get together and they had the National Alliance.
Yeah.
AKA NAMI.
NAMI.
So they estimate that 10 million Americans live with seasonal affective disorder, AKA SAD.
What the fuck is this?
Oh my
God. Sounds like an allergy. Yeah.
Seasonal affective disorder?
They named it that to make it sad. And so that they could sell you a fucking, like, what can we do with SAD that makes it sound legitimate?
This SAD is, so we have four seasons here in North America.
California only has one.
Yeah. We have two. We have like a kind of cold and then a hot.
Like a spring and a summer.
Okay. That's all we got. Yeah.
That's true. There's four, right? So that means that there's four chances someone can be like, is it like horoscopes and shit? Like I'm a summer sad kind of guy, or like I'm a winter sad.
They only talk about two. So it's winter time sad and summertime sad.
So no one gets upset during fall and spring?
Nope.
I think it has to do with the way the sky looks, like the color of the sky. Like if it's blue and sunny, it's like one thing, and then if it's cloudy or rainy, it's another thing.
Yeah, so they're saying that summer sad is similar to the winter blues. And so they're saying that during the summer, a lot of people, they tend to lose weight. They tend to be really...
Because they're trying to get pussy in Cancun.
That's right.
Oh, is that what?
Spring break. They get really anxious and stuff.
Oh, they get sad because they don't get the pussy in Cancun.
Yeah.
Or because they can't shed that weight and get those abs going.
Well, it seems like summer, like everyone around you is like always constantly doing things, and I guess people that suffer with this, if they don't keep themselves busy, then they get really sad.
Like they wasted like their summer?
Like FOMO?
I guess it's like a FOMO.
What'd you say?
FOMO.
What the hell is that?
Fear of missing out.
Oh. Loser.
No, just FOMO. Like
so
a
losers
lot of people,
get sad.
No, a lot of people have that FOMO. It's not like a clinical thing.
Right? I get sad. You got something to say then? You got something to say to me, dude? I get sad, dude. You got something to say to me, dude?
Yeah, you're a loser.
You're a loser.
Okay, my bad. I don't really want to fight you.
Like, sometimes I feel FOMO. Like, if everyone's going out and like for Tiff's wedding, it was major FOMO. I'm like,
I felt like a loser.
Oh, well, no, I didn't feel like a loser. But...
Yeah, I'm like, I wish I was there, but I can't be there, so I'm a loser. I think it's okay to feel like a loser.
I guess he has his own definition for loser.
You feel lame. Yeah.
Like I wish I was there, but I can't. So
like a loner.
Yeah.
Like loner can be negative, but it's also okay to own that loner title.
Nah, dude, loner.
Sometimes you get so comfortable with the feeling of loneliness that when you're around people, you feel uncomfortable. So you go back to the sad, lonely place because you're more familiar.
Those are called turtles.
That was deep.
But I'm a turtle.
That was really perfect.
Oh, is that you? Does that happen?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. I think that like I'm just more comfortable feeling sad.
Aww.
Yeah.
Oh, welcome to a little glimmer of what I do. Little tiny little little speck of dust.
And that's why you're both comedians.
There you go.
The funniest, happiest people are also the saddest.
No, I love that you're bringing in this perspective, right? Because a lot of us, we either don't know that we do that ourselves, or, you know, you have someone that says loser. So it's cool to bring in
but
that
everyone's perspective. Everyone's a loser every once in a while.
He's like my dad. My dad just says that.
He's like, you're being a little loser right now.
That's probably why I feel more comfortable being sad.
Like, yeah, during their wedding, everyone was like, everyone was dressed nice in suits and dresses and stuff. And then I'm like wearing PJs at home. I'm like, damn, I look pretty loserish right now.
Yeah, and then he's like, guess what I'm doing?
Pooping. In the middle of the speeches, we're FaceTiming. He's like, oh, I'm pooping.
He stops the whole speech.
He couldn't have timed it.
Yeah.
I know, he stopped the whole
speech. In our defense, we didn't know what was happening because it was very pixelated.
I had no idea if anyone was giving a speech. I didn't know.
That was funny, though.
I was in the middle of speeching, giving a speech to you.
We couldn't even hear it. It was so broken up. Yeah, so we were just like, fuck.
It was perfect timing, though. It was like a moment between like her like Skyping to you guys and then Bart's like, that's awesome. Guess what I'm doing right now, guys? Pooping.
So your my speech like to you is butchered as hell.
Just a grown little boy.
I didn't even get to say what I wanted to say. I got interrupted by the poop.
Interpooped.
We were crying. What were we crying about? I forgot.
The whole thing.
Loser.
No, well, anyways, going back to this thing, though. So they're saying with the winter time sad, it's the opposite where people, they gain weight, they tend to oversleep, and they get really sluggish. And then so it's due to, like, decreased levels of serotonin, which is the feel-good.
Those guys just need a snowboard. You'll feel awesome.
Because sun actually gives you, that antidepressant.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Yeah, and so... apparently there are two theories, that one, that summer sad is biological, and another, that it's behavioral and psychological.
Yeah.
Do the summer sad people also get winter sad? Or is it like one or the other? Like,
yeah, or do people get both?
Well, you can get sad. Okay, so like you can get sad in either season, I feel like, when it's overcast. I don't have a reason to be sad. But I'll know it's overcast because I feel this feeling of dread, like the world's gonna end. Like I feel
like a low energy,
an impending sense of doom. No, like I want to hide under a bed. Like I feel like people are trying to get me. Like it's like scary.
That's nuts.
But like there's no reason to feel that way, and I can logically talk myself out of it. I feel like I'm a functioning like.
Well, some people are affected by the moon.
But yeah,
dude,
women are really connected to the moon.
You know, like when the moon is full, statistically, correlation is not causation, but there's a lot more crimes happening in the world.
Well, that's when the werewolves are out.
Probably see better at night.
That's probably why.
Oh, that's why. That makes sense.
I would think they want to be hidden if they.
Exactly. That's what I was. I'm like, wait, why
they're just not smart.
Can you just see better?
I know, but if you could see better, that means you could be seen better.
Yeah, but the people that should be seeing, they're inside because they're scared of the werewolves.
But they could use flashlights when they're burglarizing or something.
Do you think that this is, we're talking about it because it's just so different? Because like everyone understands like, oh, when it's sunny and everything's like.
You should be happy.
You should be happy.
Odd. I think it's okay to say it's odd. I think it's like, hey, it's a beautiful day. I'm depressed about it.
I would say it's odd if it's not psychological because of the vitamin D. It would make more sense that you would be happy when the sun's out because you're getting the antidepressant. But I don't know, there's other people like Steve that like hates brightness. Like he would rather be in a cave all day. He doesn't like it when it's
But he doesn't
sunny.
Seem sad though.
But he doesn't get sad. Yeah, he just
I have the same mood everywhere I go. I can complain about anything.
Yeah.
I could be on a water slide right now and have the same expression. That's it. I was like this on my wedding day.
No, he cried.
Yeah, I cried cause I was getting married, dude. Ha ha ha, you know,
I don't get it.
Cause like he's happy.
Yeah, I think it's odd when like if you know these things happen, like there's summer, what is it called, summer sad, and then winter blues.
Summertime.
Right.
So if you
know those things are gonna happen, then if you prevent that from happening, then you're good, right? Like in the winter, if you know that's gonna come, then you just pack yourself with a bunch of activities.
But she just said that
and
logically.
Also stay, and then stay in the sun.
Yeah.
And so get more vitamin D and you prevent that.
She said she does that.
Yeah.
So in the winter, plan a trip to Hawaii.
Go to freaking Hawaii. Yeah.
She functions and everything's,
so you
she
get
gets
the sun,
it.
So the vitamin D doesn't even work on you.
No, and also I have a problem absorbing it. Like, I take extra vitamin D, I go out in the sun, and like I run, like I do.
You look like you absorb it well. You look, thank you. Yeah.
But it just, thank you. It doesn't, like, the chemical, though, that, like, makes it not.
It just doesn't kick in?
Sad. No, it doesn't. Like, I got tested, and I was deficient in vitamin D, and I've been chronically deficient in vitamin D.
She should just go to Disney, dude, I think.
I don't know.
Go to Disney.
I gotta get more D, yeah.
I'll give her more D.
I'm in constant need of D.
I'll do that, and then you go to Disney and have a bunch of kids yelling in your ear while you're sad. I mean, that's...
Oh, fuck.
I hope you guys enjoyed this video. For more, please subscribe to our channel. And you can check out the last video right here.